Good morning, all of you early birds. We are here at the Clarence Dew Burns Arena in beautiful Inner Harbor, downtown Baltimore, to bring you the first bout of the 2011 WFTDA East Region Playoffs, featuring the number 8 and 9 seeds, the Dutchland Derby Rollers All-Stars versus the Maine Port Authorities. I'm Max the Axe. With me is Pixie Quick and Witty.
Hello, everyone out there in Derby Land, and thank you so much for tuning in. We are coming to you live thanks to Blaze Streaming Media, and we are very excited for this bout. The teams are going through their pre-bout rituals right now. As many of the Maine fans know, they just did their cheer, and that's one of their pre-bout rituals, and I'm sure Dutchland has some of their own.
Well, you may be able to hear in the background the sound of cowbells, and if you're from the Lancaster, Pennsylvania area, or Lancaster as they call it, there you can never have enough cowbell. I've heard that sentiment repeated across the country, and certainly in the Derby world, but in Lancaster they take it seriously, and wherever these All-Stars go, Pixie, the cowbells go with them.
Absolutely. I mean, coming from the land of the Amish, I'm surprised they don't have wooden pointy-toed roller skates and a handful of tulips.
Well, this bout is the premier bout of the day. There are going to be several more, as those of you watching faithfully at home, I'm sure, know. But this is an interesting bout in a number of ways. Two teams that have faced each other and in the East have taken on some mutual opponents. And if there's anything to be said for the triangle, analysis, Pixie, this could be a very close bout.
Absolutely. I think these teams are so well matched. They played each other back on March 36th, and Dutchland prevailed that day by 52 points. But a lot of change-ups have happened in both of their teams since then. They have both played comparable teams. For example, Maine played DC and won by 81 points. Shortly before that, Dutchland played DC and they won only by 28 points. So that's a pretty big point spread. You know, Dutchland played Boston, won by 38.
Pixie, we're getting
also
excuse me for interrupting. We're getting ready to go.
We are. Oh, my goodness. They are starting right on time. First game of the Big Five in the WFTDA Championships, and this is the 2011 East Regional Playoffs. Nightmare on 95. I don't know about nightmare, though. I think this is kind of a rock and roll fantasy rather than a nightmare.
Well, at 10 a.m., it certainly isn't a nightmare yet. Maybe later on it could be. But both of these teams are vying for the honor of playing Gotham, the number one seeded team in the East in regionals. On the line for Dutchland to start this first jam off is Skid Ho.
And starting off for Maine Roller Derby, we have number 305, Grim Demise, a favorite jammer on Maine Roller Derby. Blocking for MRD, we have Crystal Whip, Shirley B. Slammin', Punchy O Guts, and Itsy Bitsy Fighter. That's quite an all-star blocking team for MRD.
Punchy O Guts, widely regarded as one of the top blockers in the East. She'll be the yeoman on the main team. And we're off. This
Here
is the
are.
First jam of the 2011 East Regional Playoff. And Grim Demise takes lead jammer just like that.
That's right. Skid Ho got knocked out early off, and Grim prevails as lead jammer.
Skid Ho still having a tough time getting through. She does now. But Grim Demise with a half-track lead. This will give her an opportunity to score a couple. She eludes Bella Loblosi and calls off the jam. And that's what Maine's going to have to do, Pixie, if
Absolutely.
They want to prevail in this bout.
Grim picked up 3 points, started off that jam right.
Nash Villain on the line for Dutchland.
And we have number 273, Spry Icicle.
Pixie, in case you didn't know, Nash Villain was a former competitive downhill ski racer, and she jams with that same kind of reckless abandon. She is a fun one to watch. Go ahead and take the play-by-play.
That's fantastic. Spry Icicle is our training manager for Maine Roller Derby, so she's got the inside track. She does get knocked down on the inside, and it looks like we have got Nash Villain out front, but she is not the lead jammer. She had a no pass, no penalty. So even though she can score points, she is not able to call off this jam. Hopefully that will be the job of Spry Icicle if Spry can get through the pack. Although she's really contending up at the front with Twisted Scissors and Milk Maiden. They are just forming that wall, holding her back. Nash Villain is through, picking up five, lapping Spry Icicle.
That's five for Nash Villain. Spry Icicle hit from behind by Twisted Scissors, but right as she got through, she was able to call off that jam.
Absolutely. A very exciting second jam. The tables turned. Dutchland took the lead back over. Let's see what Maine can do in this next jam.
In the early going, a lot of hard play in the pack. Dutchland's got a skater in the penalty box. Bella Loblosi and V Diva teaming up on Spry Icicle in that last jam, Pixie.
Absolutely. And starting off on the jam line for Maine Roller Derby, it looks like we have Grim Demise again.
Grim Demise is in good shape. She will be able to jam a lot for the Port Authorities. Wearing the star for Dutchland is White Thrash, and neither one's through just yet.
White Thrash looks like she's right up at the front of the pack. She did get a no pass, no penalty, so it's yet to be determined. And she does not have... I'm sorry, she...
Jammer on jammer action by Grim Demise, and she takes full advantage at fast, full stride skating, and that's going to send White Thrash for a loop. Grim Demise rockets through the pack and calls it off, Pixie.
Excellent call by Grim. You know, she is such a smart jammer. In addition to being incredibly fun to watch, you know, there are so many times when both of her feet come off the track because they're moving so fast, but, you know... On top of that, she just reads the pack really well. She knows when to call it. She's a coach's dream. She's a fan's dream.
If you haven't noticed already, Maine in the white, Dutchland in their signature Halloween colors, orange and black. And we have V Diva on the jam line now in her first jam of the morning for Dutchland. V Diva, of course, the transfer from Lehigh Valley. She has rocked the Derby world by being selected as one of the members of the Team USA All-Star World Cup team. And she shows her form right there, busting through the pack, Pixie. She is out in front and running.
And Crystal Whip is through the pack for Maine Roller Derby. She's jamming. She does not have the lead jammer, but Crystal Whip is quick on her feet, and hopefully, well.
V Diva sees the situation, calls it off, picks up the four, hits and quits, and that could be trouble for Maine if V Diva continues with her, I don't know if you remember football way back when I was a kid, but Earl Campbell. V Diva reminds me of the Earl Campbell of jammers. Big, strong, but amazingly agile Pixie.
Absolutely. All right, starting off in the jam line for MRD, we have Itsy Bitsy Fighter, one of our most versatile players. And for Dutchland, we have Skid Ho, number 18. Dutchland has a really good rotating panel of jammers. Itsy Bitsy Fighter has the benefit of being both a jammer and a blocker and being able to analyze the pack in that way. No lead jammer as of yet. Skid Ho goes down. So Itsy Bitsy Fighter has a bit of an opportunity if she can get that past that wall of Twisted Scissors and Spinal Snap.
Skid Ho busts through. Lil Punisher was knocking her around, Pixie, but she busts through with second effort.
Wow. Dutchland has got a three wall up front there, and they are not letting that go. Itsy Bitsy Fighter taking some jammer and jammer action on, but Skid Ho gets around that wall and leaps. Itsy picks up five.
That's the big enchilada for Skid Ho. Dutchland's going to have to regroup, and they slow down, giving Skid Ho an opportunity to lap the pack again.
Really, Itsy is just needing some help up at the front for to bust through that three wall. And it's taking the blockers a little bit of time to figure out where the weaknesses are. But they keep on splitting apart and reforming that wall.
Skid Ho with another grand slam for Dutchland. Itsy Bitsy Fighter has not seen defense like this in quite a while, Pixie.
Pack is completely slowed down. This is really allowing Skid Ho to just rack up the points. And every time Itsy thinks she finds a hole, it seems like the Dutchland blockers just go and plug it up. And slow the pack right down and allow their jammer to run through. It looks like this might be their MO. Itsy does find that hole on the outside of the pack.
And just as soon as she does, Skid Ho calls that one off. A major blow, the first big shot taken in this game. Let's see what Maine can do to counterpunch, Pixie.
Yeah, that was tough. Dutchland's at 29, Maine is at 7, but they just put Grim Demise in on the jam line. They've got Crystal Whip, Itsy Bitsy Fighter, May Snap, and Shirley B. Slamming up front. So hopefully they can come back in this jam.
Nash Villain on the line for Dutchland going up against Grim Demise. And if you want anybody to make up some space for you, as if you're Maine, you want it to be Grim Demise. V Diva gets her signals crossed and knocks out her own jammer. Nash Villain goes flying, and that springs Grim Demise lead jammer. Nash Villain's going to have to make up a lot of room in a short period of time.
Absolutely. And let's not forget that Dutchland right now has a blocker in the box. Twisted Scissors is sitting this one out.
Grim Demise with a smart move. She's not going to get all of that lead back in one jam, but she picks up two. Nash Villain gets nothing. And that's something that I think Maine can work on as this bout progresses, Pixie, is that Dutchland, they play with heart. They play with intensity, but you can misdirect them sometimes, and I think that's what the Maine pack did in that one. V Diva was going for the knockout punch, the jammer takedown. She ended up taking out her own jammer.
Absolutely. On the line for MRD, we have Spry Icicle, and it looks like we have White Thrash for Dutchland.
Spry Icicle in the lead right now, but White Thrash now out in front. Can she hold on? Well, she's going to get around. She's not lead jammer. No pass, no penalty, says Jason Singer. And as we progress in this jam, now Spry Icicle gets through. She's not lead jammer either, so this one's going to go the full 2 minutes, Pixie.
Wow, full two-minute jam this early on in the game is going to exhaust these skaters. I will tell you what.
I tell you, you're the home announcer for Maine. Did this team come down yesterday? Oh, it's now a power jam for Maine. This is just what Spry Icicle needed, but she's going to have to get some help. Well, she got some help from the back of her pack, a no-pack situation, and she's going to get a big four. Now Maine's going to try to hold off Renegade Raven. They can't quite do it. Dutchland's going to try to run away with this, but I see Maine breaking up that wall.
We've got two really smart blockers out there. We've got Little Punisher. I mean, they're all smart, but Little Punisher and Shirley B. Slam, and they know how to sort of insert themselves into that wall, separate one blocker from that pack, and slow the pack down.
Twisted
Hopefully.
Scissors called off on that last attempted jammer takedown. She was outside of the pack, outside of the engagement zone. That puts Grim Demise back on top, and she's making up the majority of those points from that last major jam.
And that would actually be Spry Icicle making up those points. Just a technicality there. But we have Dutchland at 29. It looks like we have Maine at 18 and rising right now.
Spry.
Unfortunately, Spry was called out and is in the penalty box.
That will start Dutchland off in a power jam situation for this next jam. White Thrash just got back on the track as that jam timed out. But this is what we expected. Hard-hitting action, kind of back and forth so far, but V Diva's going to take the line unopposed. The good news for Maine is that there are two Dutchland blockers in the box. So out there trying to hold on are
absolutely
Bella Loblosi and Rumman Choke.
I wouldn't
for
be
Dutchland.
Surprised if Maine tried to race the pack, and there they go. They are, and those Dutchland blockers have no choice but to keep up with them because the pack is the largest number of skaters, you know, composed of members of both teams. So Maine really needs to race it as best they can.
V Diva holds her edge around the corner. She gets around May Snap. That will be lead jammer, but Maine did a good job of holding her off for quite some time. She didn't just bust her way right through that pack, Pixie.
No, and you know, Maine is trying to reconstitute their front wall of four. V Diva does get through, does pick up five, but you know, if Little Punisher, who's goated at the back of the pack here, can get through, then they can race this pack once again.
Twisted Scissors back on the track, but Rumman Choke's going to have to sit down. That's going to keep Dutchland at a disadvantage. V Diva's going to have to reestablish her position as she was knocked out of bounds in turn number three.
And here comes Spry Icicle back on the track, and that means that V Diva chooses to call this jam. We are at 42:18 with about just under 18 minutes left in this half.
If you're just tuning in, Maine in the white, the Port Authorities from the beautiful city of Portland, Maine, going up against, they're the number 9 seed this year, going up against the number 8 seed, the Dutchland Derby Rollers All-Stars out of Lancaster, Pennsylvania. They're in their orange and black. This is Max the Axe and Pixie Quick and Witty. Who do we have on the jam line, Pixie?
We have Grim Demise jamming for Maine Roller Derby, and it looks like we've got Skid Ho jamming for Dutchland.
Grim Demise with the athletic move gets lead jammer. How about that, Pixie?
That, you know, is typical of Grim's MO. When she gets lead, she tends to get it quick, right off. You know, she plays smart. She'll, you know, probably get through this time around, pick up her points, whatever points she can get, and call the jam before Skid Ho hits the pack. 4 points for Grim. You know, sometimes bouts are won 4 points at a time.
You've got that right. And Grim Demise with a head on a swivel right there saw just what was going on and called the action just in the nick of time.
Well, this has been a really exciting game so far. Only a 20-point spread, you know.
That's
one power jam. You know, I mean, sometimes games are won in power jams, but
on the line for Dutchland now is Twisted Scissors, but how about Crystal Whippin', her first jam of the morning. She slides through on the inside. Punchio Guts made plenty of room for her. Rumman Choke's going to be back on the track for Dutchland, but
Crystal Whip
is engaging the pack, and Twisted Scissors hasn't even made it through once yet. Crystal Whip can't quite make the inside. She lost her footing. She had the hole, but couldn't quite get around Rumman Choke. Now Crystal Whip's got a decision to make, Pixie, as the Dutchland jammer, Twisted Scissors, is approaching the pack. Crystal Whip calls it off, and it looks like a 3-0. And that's a pretty good result for Maine. Crystal Whip getting through quickly, and of course establishing lead so important in this game. We have a timeout on the track. We want to thank Blaze Streaming Media for providing this fantastic video feed for the streaming coverage of the 2011 WFTDA East Regional Playoffs. What this one's known as is the Nightmare on 95. It's hosted by the Charm City Roller Girls along with DC. DC, they're co-hosting, and they've done a wonderful job. The Dew Burns Arena, for those of you who haven't been here before, is an excellent venue for roller derby. Derby. We have a fast but fair skate track track that our skate court track.
It looks like we are back, and we have Grim Demise on the jam line for Maine Roller Derby, and then we have White Thrash for Dutchland. Dutchland has formed a three wall up front. Grim Demise is contending with the center of that, but Maine has formed a two wall at the back, and White Thrash is bumping up against that one. So it's all about who can bust the wall first. White Thrash up front duking it out with Little Punisher. Little Punisher knocks her out. And it looks like we do have a lead jammer. That would be White Thrash.
White Thrash able to get back up on her feet. Oh, and how about that move as Grim Demise jukes out the Dutchland blocker and sends her flying off the track with her own momentum, Pixie.
Absolutely. White Thrash knocks down two MRD blockers. I think that that is a major back block, and that is sending her to the box. Grim Demise on a power jam. This is something that you do not want to see. Picked up five right there. She is quickly moving around. The pack is completely slowed down by the MRD blockers, holding one Dutchland blocker at the back. Grim is in the inside. She's through. V Diva is out on a fourth minor. That's another 5 points for Grim Demise, and here she comes back around again. MRD blockers at the back, holding the Dutchland folks back, making them slow it down for Grim to pick up another five.
Grim Demise takes the inside. Good pack control by Maine, as all of a sudden Dutchland having penalty difficulties galore. They've only got two skaters on the track. Grim Demise is going to make the most of this.
Grim Demise looks like she's going to take the lead over in this pass, Max. It seems like the score right now is 42-40. If Grim can get her hips past these skaters.
And she does, holding on the inside track. She evades Hillbilly Hellcat. Well, it's just like we said at the beginning, Pixie. If you triangulate the games that these teams have played against mutual opponents, it's very close. This game could go either way.
It is. They are so well matched. I am so excited that this is the first bout of the 2011 WFTDA Eastern Regional Playoffs, because it is a great bout so far.
And we have an official's timeout called on the track. They're getting as excited as everybody else, I suppose. We do want to let you know about the WFTDA. If you're not familiar with the history of the fine organization that's running the show here at this tournament, along with the other region playoffs, the Women's Flat Track Derby Association was formed in 2004 and is a volunteer-run amateur sports organization. The mission of the WFTDA is to promote and foster the sport of women's flat track roller derby by facilitating the development of athletic ability, sportswomanship, and goodwill among member leagues.
Okay, here we go. We are starting off with Shirley B. Slammin' on a power jam for Maine Roller Derby. We've got two Dutchland skaters in the box. V Diva and Spinal Snap are sitting this one out. Although, it looks like, is that Spinal Snap?
White Thrash.
White Thrash, I'm sorry.
Wearing the star for Dutchland, but
there we go. Shirley B. Slammin' picked up that lead jam, and White Thrash is still contending with Itsy Bitsy Fighter.
She gets through. Now, Let's see what Dutchland has for defense. V Diva knocks out Shirley B. Slammin'. Bella Loblosi up front along with Spinal Snap as White Thrash enters the fray as well. She's got Punchio Guts to contend with.
Unfortunately, Shirley B. Slammin' got knocked out of bounds by V Diva. V Diva held her back. She had to skate backwards in order to get around her, and there was no points, but smartly, Shirley B. Slammin' did call off the jam once White Thrash got through that pack. So.
White Thrash picked up two. It is dog-eat-dog in the first period of this first bout. Dutchland up 47-45. If you're just tuning in, Dutchland in the black with the orange shorts, and Maine in the white with the blue bottoms.
Just about 11 minutes left in this period. Here we go. Grim Demise going up against Skid Ho. We've seen this pairing before. Skid Ho hits the wall of MRD blockers up at the front and goes down. And Grim Demise contending with the wall of blockers at the back. We have a lead jammer. That would be Skid Ho. She snuck by May Snap up at the front, but Grim Demise is not too far behind her. So we'll see what we can do.
Second effort, so important to these jammers, especially at this level. An Itsy Bitsy Fighter sends the Dutchland jammer, Skid Ho, flying with a just an amazing jammer takedown,
that
Pixie.
That was quite a hit, and that was a 0-0 jam, so we are still within 2 points of each other. You know, this is what Derby is all about. These are the games that we want to see where it's a fight to the finish, and this one is going to be a fight to the finish. You just saw Sprite Icicle on the monitor there jamming for MRD.
Nash Villain taking the jam line for Dutchland, and Dutchland likes to see Nash Villain up there. Nash Villain's one of those skaters who has always got a 20 or 30 point jam up her sleeve. It just all depends. But what a nice little move by Shirley B. Slamming to
absolutely
hold
Nash Villain out. I mean, MRD is down two blockers to start off here, and so Nash Villain did get the lead jam, but I'm telling you, she had to fight for it a little bit there.
Second effort by Nash Villain gets her through, and she is out there by herself right now as Maine having a hard time. This will become a power jam now. Maine's got defense to play, and they need to play it now. Maine in the white, of course, as the skaters take a tumble in the pack. Dutchland slows this thing down for Nash Villain. She's off to the races. That's another big enchilada. 5 points, grand slam.
And MRD is down a blocker. Crystal Lip in the box right now. MRD has a three wall at the back, but Little Punisher, even though she tried to sneak through the center of that wall, could not get to Nash Villain in time. She's just moving too fast, and the pack is really slow right now.
Nash Villain showing a preternatural ability to hold on to her line right on the outside of the track. It's not something that a lot of skaters can do, but again, this track is fast and fair. I was talking with a couple of the skaters earlier today, and they said it's grippy, but it's not too grippy. Now Nash Villain busts through again. This was the jam that Dutchland needed. We said at the beginning of this one, Nash Villain's always got a big jam up her sleeve. Now it's a fair fight as Spry Icicle gets back out on the track. Punchio Guts out in front, but she's going to have to let Nash Villain go. Renegade Raven sprung from the penalty box as well. Nash Villain calls that one off, but a big jam, a 25-point jam for Nash Villain with 8 minutes left in this first period.
That was a huge jam, Max. That was points upon points upon points. And good for Nash Villain for, you know, being able to just rock it out with her pack. It looks like we have a timeout for MRD. Dutchland is conferring on the track. And what do we have? What do we have coming up later on today?
Oh, we've got derby after derby after derby. For those
Absolutely.
Of you who haven't checked out the brackets, WFTDA is running a fill out the brackets and get yourself some exciting prizes if you fill them out right. And that's across the nation, across the world these 2011 championships, Pixie.
That's right, Max. Our next game, we have the Carolina Roller Girls going up against the London Roller Girls. We're so excited that London is here. They jumped across the pond.
What a dream match. And, you know, watching on Blaze Streaming Media is about the epicenter of Derby World right now. And what a great way to do it. I mean, I'm sure that, you know, there's probably, you know, if I weren't calling this game, I'd be at work. And to those of you at work right now who are watching Derby, I say good on you, mate.
I salute you for watching Derby at work.
And that's going to be a great one. Sasha and Victim and Lady O are going to bring you that bout. V-Diva blasts through as we're back into action, showing that Team USA form. Look at that low stride. Again, she can make up a lot of room in two strides. Now she hits the pack, but Maine's shoring up the defense. V-Diva gets through for a quick five.
We've got Little Punisher jamming for Maine Roller Derby, and she really is fighting with the center wall that Dutchland has put up. V-Diva approaches the pack again and is through for another five.
V-Diva, that's a 1-2 punch between Nash Villain and V-Diva. Two completely different skating styles, but both can be lethally effective, and it makes it hard to put together a defensive strategy when you've got one punishing skater like V-Diva and another slasher like Nash Villain.
And we've got Little Punisher in the box for a major track cut. She did cut the last blocker on her pass, and so unfortunately this is a power jam for Dutchland. This would be their second power jam in a row, so that's going to hurt MRD.
V-Diva gets a free pass for another grand slam. Now Punchio Guts and Rexzilla and Itsy Bitsy Fighter are just going to have to dig deep and hold off V-Diva. And you don't want this going into halftime. And how about that? Itsy Bitsy Fighter worked hard. V-Diva called off for a back block, and that's just what Maine had to do. I said dig deep, and that's what Itsy Bitsy Fighter did. I saw her hold her knee. I hope that was just a problem with her skate pad and not a problem with her knee, Pixie.
And Spry Icicle is going to come in now that V-Diva is out. And it looks like that is the end of that jam. V-Diva picked up 4 points on the last pass. And, of course, Spry Icicle is back on the track but couldn't really do anything with the little amount of time that there was left in that jam.
If Maine comes back in this bout, that play by Itsy Bitsy Fighter may very well be the one that makes the difference, because that was a gutsy move. She had V-Diva knocked solid, but V-Diva called off for the back block.
Okay, and we have Grim Demise on a power jam for Maine Roller Derby. And as I've said before, if there's anybody you want on a power jam for MRD, it would be Grim. She really has the moves. And she was knocked out, but it looked like the other skater went down. So that was a no pass, no penalty for her. She still has the opportunity to take lead. Jammer contending with a three wall at the front. And Crystal Whip takes down Hillbilly Hellcat.
Grim Demise trying to fight her way through, but Hillbilly Hellcat and Twisted Scissors up front just having none of that. This is a defensive stand penalty killing at its finest for Dutchland right now, and a surprising penalty kill because Grim Demise just has so much talent.
And we've got V-Diva back on the track. So now we have two jammers. This is anybody's jam, and it looks like we've got a lead jammer in V-Diva.
V-Diva showing that power as she just basically moved May Snap off the line. And she is coming out. This is going to be another power jam.
Grim Demise in the box on a major track cut. And we also have Hillbilly Hellcat going into the box for Dutchland.
Clock moving down to 3 minutes and some change. V-Diva looks a little winded out there. She's been jamming a long time, and it's not easy to continue that full out sprint.
Absolutely not. She calls that jam after she picks up that last 5 points. Quite a point spread at the end, you know, nearing the end of this first half. 106 Dutchland in the black and 45 for MRD in the white.
Maine caught up, Pixie, and all of a sudden Dutchland showed another gear. We're going to see whether that will continue. Starting unopposed will be Skid Ho for the All-Stars, the Dutchland All-Stars in black, of course.
That's Maine in
white.
Crystal. Right up front for Maine, we've got Punchio Guts, Spry Icicle, and Crystal Whip. All three very versatile players.
Skid Ho looks to the inside. Oh, and how about that shot by Nash Villain? That one could earn Nash Villain a trip to the penalty box.
I think so. I think Crystal Whip might have gotten in the face right there. That must have hurt a little bit. Skid Ho having some speed. Maine trying to hold the wall at the back. takes the inside against Punchy O'Guts and picks up four.
Jolene Jawbreaker working inside. Now the pack's going to try to speed up for Maine. Smart play, but they've got Grim Shirley B. Slamming in the back. They're going to have to catch her up.
Absolutely. Dutchland only has two blockers on the track, so hopefully MRD can hold Skid Ho back, and they did just put that wall through. Grim Demise is not going to be picking up any points. Skid Ho makes sure of that, calling off this jam.
Skid Ho looks around into turn number three, says, Grim Demise is getting ready to hit this pack. I'd better pull the plug.
Yes. Now, I have to tell you, Max, statistically speaking, Maine is a second half team. So, even though the point spread is what it is right now, I'm just letting everybody know that it's not over yet.
I have no doubt in your prognostication ability, Pixie. They don't call you quick and witty for nothing. We're back to the action now. And the pack is slowing down, trying to give a Grim Demise a chance to pop out for lead jammer for Maine. She's having a tough time of it. White Thrash not having a very easy go herself for Dutchland. Oh, she evades on the inside, and she got around Itsy Bitsy Fighter. Grim Demise, with second effort, gets through as well. This is going to be a quick hit situation. As White Thrash hits her hips right as she hits the pack, and we'll see if she picked up anything, Pixie. I'm not sure
like
she did.
It looks like two double zeros on that one. Absolutely, double zeros. So we have about 41 seconds left in this half.
This may very well be the last jam, folks. We've got a lot of roller derby action coming your way today.
It's kind of a rough last half of this period. Maine has not scored in the last 13 minutes or so. Dutchland's been really holding them back. I think that Maine is going to have to go back to those locker rooms and reconfer. Crystal Whip jamming for MRD in what looks to be the last jam of this first half.
On the jam, wearing the star for Dutchland. She works her way through, but she's called for a minor cut. She will not be lead jammer. She's still in scoring position, though, as Crystal Whip having a hard time with this wall of black. Twisted Sister, Spinal Snap, Treasure
Treasure
Chest.
And we've got 5 points for Skid Ho.
Dutchland putting on a defensive showing to end this first period. The jam will most likely time out at this point, since Crystal Whip is having a hard time getting through. Now she does, but she's not lead jammer either. So this one's going to go the full 2 minutes, Pixie.
We've got Spinal Snap out on a major back block. It looks like we also have one other blocker in the box, and I cannot see her number from here. But so Dutchland is down to two blockers in this last jam, maybe giving Crystal Whip a little bit of a chance to pick up some points. And she calls it. She says it's not worth it. And here we are in the halftime. Well, what do you think, Max?
I think Dutchland pulled into overdrive after this game got tied up, Pixie. Unbelievable showing. It was 45-45. Maine had clawed their way back. As you said, Maine historically a second half team. So, you know, this thing is far from written in the history books right now. Don't forget, the winner of this bout has to play again today against the number one seed in the quarterfinals.
6 o'clock tonight, Gotham.
In the quarterfinals. And, you know, a lot of skaters would kill for the opportunity to be in this situation, to be wearing the uniforms of either Maine or Dutchland right now. But Maine's going to have to go in, regroup, find a way to get through and break up the blocking between Renegade Raven, Hillbilly Hellcat, Bella Loblosi in her first bout for the Dutchland All-Stars, and of course Treasure Chest. I think it's the pack play that's really made the difference so far.
You know, I think you're right, Max. I think that both teams have some really great jammers. I think that where the game is hinging is really upon the defensive work. And so many fans know that it is so much about defense in roller derby. It's so much about, you know, whether you can form a wall, whether once the wall has been broken up, you can reconstitute it somewhere else, whether the wall needs to be in the front or the back, or, you know, split between both. And I think that that is where Maine is getting hung up. You know, Dutchland has really solid, you can tell that they have really solidly drilled in wall formation and reformation and reformation after that.
And taking nothing away from Nash Villain and V Diva, some of the high scorers for Dutchland in this first period, but those were power jams. And
right.
Power jams can sometimes happen almost as a fluke. I mean, you always have to be ready for them. And, you know, if you are on the wrong end of a power jam, you have to be able to solidify your pack. But so far, so good for the Dutchland pack skaters and their jammers as well. Maine's going to have to regroup, but we know they can do it, Pixie.
Absolutely. And we are going to take a quick break, and we will be back for the second half of Dutchland versus Maine. 11 East Region playoffs, the first bout of the Big Five for the WFTDA. My name is Pixie Quick and Witty, and I am your hostess, your online hostess for this evening. And with me, I have Max the Axe.
So good to be here and glad you're with us. Pull up your coffee, enjoy yourselves, and we've got second period action between the number 8 seed Dutchland and the number 9 seed Port Authorities from Maine. If you're just tuning in, Maine in the white, Dutchland in the black, and the referees are making sure that everything is ready to go. Interesting first half, a battle, and all of a sudden Dutchland took off, Pixie, and scored the last 50 some points.
Absolutely. Starting off on the jam line for MRD, we have Grim Demise and Skid Ho for Dutchland. It looks like Grim is fighting for the lead jam. She takes the outside. She does not get the lead jam. She does get the lead jam. I thought there was a no pass, no penalty there. That's what the ref was signaling initially. Now we are seeing that Grim Demise is the lead jammer. Picking up points on this first pass, contending with Rum and Choke at the front and dodging on the inside.
Punchy O'Guts coming out with a bunch of energy after that break, and she knocks Skid Ho for a loop. Skid Ho's lucky to still be on her feet, Pixie.
Grim picks up 5 on the inside for that pass, and it looks like we have a fourth minor, a track cut, being assigned to Skid Ho, so she is going to be spending time in the penalty box. This is where Maine needed to start this jam, on a power jam with their Grim Demise serving as their jammer. And there she goes through for 5 again, picking up that extra point for lapping the other team's jammer.
Punchy O'Guts, Little Punisher, are just doing a great job in the pack right now for Maine. They're making room for Grim Demise, and I think they just frustrated the daylights out of Twisted Scissors and the other jammer, Skid Ho, for Dutchland, and Skid Ho picked up that fourth minor. Here comes Grim Demise. Dutchland trying to run away with it, but
Maine's running this pack as slow as they possibly can for Grim so that she can go picking up her 5. There she goes. She picks up that last 5 and calls it so that we start this next jam with a Dutchland jammer in the box. Smart, Max, smart.
25-point jam for Grim Demise. Starting off the second period, do you think Maine planned that in the locker room, Pixie?
I don't know if you can plan that. She is such a hot ticket, and she really had a star panel of blockers. And now we've got three main skaters on their knees with Spry Icicles starting that jam off for MRD.
Bella Loblosi and Treasure Chest blocking for Dutchland. And if you want two blockers to try to kill a penalty, there are a couple of good ones. Now Treasure Chest has to try to hold off Spry Icicle. Let's see whether she can do it.
And it looks like we do have a lead jammer. Spry Icicle is the lead jammer. She's still having a really, her hips past Treasure Chest, but she's still having a really hard time getting past her physically. Treasure Chest was out of play.
She's
out on a major, and Spry calls it.
Spry Icicle, though, very wisely seeing what was happening with Skid Ho there, coming in off the bench. Spry Icicle, good awareness on the track, realizing she was lead jammer, even though she and Twisted Scissors were doing the tango, rumba, whatever you want to say. I'm not up on all the ballroom dance moves, but... smart play to call that one off, maintaining Maine's momentum, Pixie.
And we've got Nashville going up against Grim Demise here. And Grim takes the lead right off the bat. Nashville getting slowed down by Shirley B. Slammin, who knocked her out and skated backwards.
Little Punisher and Itsy Bitsy Fighter working over Nash Villain. She goes down. She's going to have to regroup. Punchio Guts sends her out of bounds, too. And Punchio Guts holding her position as Grim Demise has a full track advantage over Nash Villain. And a little jammer on jammer blocking to boot.
Grim takes the inside, picks up five. Nash Villain doesn't want to let her do that again. And we've got the end of that jam. Wow, Maine coming out explosive. Now, I did say.
I have it written.
I don't mean to tell you so, but Maine is a second half team. They really are. They, for whatever reason, when they reconstitute at the halftime, and you know, this may not bear upon the ending of the game, but they really do come out strong in the second half, and I just love that about them.
Well, you've made a believer of me, and they've made a believer as well. I'm sure you at home are feeling the same way. All of a sudden, they go from 45 points to 80 points, and Dutchland hasn't scored in this period yet, Pixie.
Yep. And we've got Crystal Whip jamming for Maine Roller Derby, a very versatile, powerful little skater. White Thrash for Dutchland goes through the center, is contending with May Snap.
White Thrash picks up lead, and Dutchland trying to pick up its first points in this second period now, Pixie. Let's see what Maine can do in the back of the pack to hold off White Thrash. White Thrash tries to dice her way on the inside, and she does get through for four.
But Crystal Whip, you know, just snuck around the front, and, you know, so she was out of that pack, and Dutchland had to call it pretty quickly. She is quite a fast skater and quite a sneaky skater. She can sort of insert herself into that hole when you don't even see her and kind of weave around blockers very easily.
Itsy Bitsy Fighter versus the Diva. Now, this will be a jam to watch. Two completely different jamming styles. The low center of gravity of Itsy Bitsy Fighter with speed and agility. Look at that first little hop move. And V Diva just with the power. She's got agility of her own, and she busts through on the outside. V Diva lead jammer. Itsy Bitsy Fighter still having a hard time getting around that front wall of Bella Loblosi and Rum and Choke.
Absolutely. Itsy Bitsy Fighter seems like she's trying to take the inside a lot and just, you know, running up against that wall of blockers, while it seems like V Diva is pretty confident taking the outside. Well, and Dutchland has slowed the pack down to a standstill.
V Diva with those long strides. She has the, you know, the smaller skaters look for the inside because it's such a shorter track around the turns. And it really is where length length is an advantage for a skater like V-Diva, who can take the outside in the same number of strides. And she's going to hit the pack again. We've got to see what Maine has in store for her. And what they have in store is a back block major on V-Diva.
Yep, V-Diva did get in the box on that. And so what Maine needs to do right now is to get Itsy Bitsy Fighter through the pack. She's not made first pass yet, so even if she's through, there's her first pass. She will be going around that turn and scoring some points, and this jam will come to its natural conclusion because it seems like it's going to run out before V-Diva gets back on the track.
Bella Loblosi now goes out on a penalty. Here comes Itsy Bitsy Fighter. There's no quitting this girl. She put that hit on V-Diva in the first half, and now she's got Rum and Choke to contend with, along with Renegade Raven and Twisted Scissors. Twisted Scissors sends Itsy Bitsy Fighter down, and there she is again holding that skate pad, Pixie. Let's hope that that's an equipment malfunction and not something wrong with that left knee.
Well, I don't know about the knee. At the 2011 ECDX, Itsy Bitsy Fighter actually broke some bones in her foot. And so Maine did not have the advantage of having her at that bout. She recovered since then, so since June. And, you know, we've been worried about that foot, but you're right. It does seem like the knee might be an issue. Grim Demise starting off on the jam line alone for MRD. And we've got two Dutchland blockers on the track. And it looks like they are just trying to race that pack, but we have a lead jammer. Grim Demise is our lead jammer, and those two Dutchland skaters, Milk Maiden and Hillbilly Hellcat, are just racing as fast as they can.
V-Diva on a mission now, sprung from the penalty box, trying to catch up with Grim Demise. Grim Demise takes the outside around Hillbilly Hellcat, can't quite shift her position, but calls it off before V-Diva can pick up anything else. So that's a profitable jam for Grim Demise and the Maine Port Authorities.
Yes, she picked up four on that last jam, which, you know, four at a time, and we've had just under 21 minutes left in this period. It looks like we have got Skid Ho starting on the jam line for Dutchland and Shirley B. Slammin for Maine Roller Derby.
Shirley B. Slammin picked up some good play in the first period. We're going to see her go up against Skid Ho for the first time, I believe. Skid Ho with a nifty move to the outside. She's going to pick up lead. Shirley B. Slammin was right behind her, but then Rum and Choke said, I'm going to hold you back in the pivot position. And that's what's happening as we go around turn number two again. Rum and Choke just seems to have Shirley B. Slammin figured out.
Shirley B. Slammin did finally commit to the inside, passing by Rum and Choke. That was a good move by her. It seemed like she was weaving back and forth, and then when she decided to commit, that's when she got by.
Skid Ho gets through on the inside, calls that one off, and it's going to be a 4-0 in favor of Dutchland.
And I wanted to mention one of our sponsors, Wicked Skatewear. They are here today, and so for those of you who don't know, Wicked Skatewear is an amazing skate shop started by skater B-Train and Strychnine, and we love them, and thank you for sponsoring the 2011 WFTDA East Region Playoffs.
White Thrash on the jam line for Dutchland. Is that Grim Demise again for the Port Authorities?
It is. That is Grim.
She's been working hard this morning, but she's the go-to jammer for the Port Authorities for Maine in the white. Maine with a strong showing so far in this second half, and Grim Demise pushes her way to the front, gets lead jammer. White Thrash can only sit back and say, hi, Punchio Guts, please let me through. And I don't think Punchio Guts is going to be any too cordial with that. Grim Demise has a grand slam to start this jam off, and White Thrash still not through. She's looking to get around Lil Punisher, but Lil Punisher's holding her off with the booty block. Now she's going to have to let her go by, but Lil Punisher did her job. Grim Demise into the pack, looking to get around Nashville and move to the outside, and she calls it off. That's a 9-point jam for Grim Demise.
Excellent, excellent positional blocking by Maine Roller Derby. It looks like, you know, they might have talked about that while reformation during the half. And, you know, they really are, this is so much closer. They're playing so well this second half. I'm really impressed with the defense.
Shirley B. Slammon now on the jam line for the Port Authorities.
And it looks like we've got Skid Ho again for Dutchland.
Dutchland going a little deeper into the jam rotation than Maine, but Shirley B. Slammon gets around. Bella Loblosi on the inside picks up lead jammer.
We've got jammer behind jammer, and I think that Shirley is just going to make her work it and call it. There we go. And that's a 0-0.
Both jam refs holding up their fists and indicating that neither team scored any points. And, you know, that, again, that's a profitable jam to some extent for Shirley B. Slammon, because at least the lead does not grow for Dutchland. And now we have V. Diva on the line.
And it looks like we've got Crystal Whip
V-Diva
on the jam line for Maine Roller Derby.
Versus Crystal Whip. Dutchland with a couple in the box. So V-Diva is going to try and do her blocking early. A little bit of jammer-on-jammer action. It's successful as Crystal Whip has to go inside and seed position. V-Diva tries to get around A-Block, and she does. A-Block's the one that goes down. Lil Punisher tries to hold off V-Diva, but she can't do it.
V-Diva, lead jammer. Excellent, excellent. In taking the inside against Little Punisher, really making her work for it. And now we've got Crystal Whip stuck behind a wall of Dutchland blockers up at the front. Hopefully we can get one of these main blockers to insert themselves in that wall, break it up a little bit so that Crystal Whip can go through. But meanwhile,
out that acrobatic maneuver on the inside track by V-Diva. Hopping up, I think she went about 15 feet in the air on that one, Pixie.
So. She's really something else to watch, I'm telling you. You know, just that big, long, powerful stride. And then, you know, when you get a jump on the inside like that, there's really nothing that compares. It's so exciting.
It's kind of a combination of ballet and rugby. And now V-Diva gets through with an assist from Twisted Scissors, and she calls off the jam.
And we've got a minor track cut on Crystal Whip, so it looks like Dutchland is going to be starting this next jam on a power jam, unfortunately. Itsy Bitsy Fighter also. We had a little bit of a hit at the end. I think she might have gotten some contact, possibly either to her knee or to the face, and so she was on the track. She fell. It looks like she's up on her skates and she's okay, but it seems like she did get hit in the face on that last jam. That was really tough.
Nash Villain, the unopposed jammer for Dutchland now. She's got a mission, and she is through as lead. She was able to get around a little Punisher. A little Punisher was doing all she could. Now Dutchland slows down the pack for Nash Villain, and this is where Nash Villain eats the other team's lunch sometimes in these power jam situations. She just has a knack for hitting that pack with so much speed.
And we had Punchy Oguts out on a direction of gameplay penalty, and it looks like we've got Nash Villain going out now. And I'm looking for the call on that one, but we've got a jammer switch off that's about to happen here. It looks like Nash Villain is taking her time to sit down. Once she does, Crystal Whip comes back on the track.
3-on-3 in the pack as Crystal Whip now has Bella Loblosi and Trezor Chest to get around on the inside. These Dutchland jammers, or blockers, excuse me, have formed themselves a big black wall, Pixie.
Absolutely. Crystal is trying to either get through it or on the outside. You know, I have to say the Dutchland blockers are being really clever about the multi-player block. You know, they're not grabbing each other. They're just putting their arms together. And, you know, that just creates that psychological barrier that I think that a lot of jammers do not dare to bust through.
They touch each other, but they're not interlocking, and no contact is initiated. That's the important difference.
That is the key.
In that situation. And, oh, dear, now Crystal Whip goes down, can't quite hold her balance. Somebody's going to have to pay for that. And it looks like it's Treasure Chest.
Yeah, that was a blocking out of bounds call on Treasure Chest. She's going to the box for that one, I think.
Nash Villain back on the track, but that jam timed out. We're going to have to sort the carnage out after the end of that bout. It got a little bit ragged towards the end. But both of these teams, you know, 10 o'clock in the morning start. That's got to play havoc with your circadian rhythms. And I bet, you know, even though they're highly trained athletes, they're probably experiencing a little bit of a low energy point right now, Pixie.
And I just wanted to mention one of our sponsors, Rydell Skates. They are a proud partner and the official skate of the WFTDA. Thank you, Rydell Sports, for sponsoring the 2011 WFTDA East Region Playoffs.
There's two whistles. The jammers start again. Grim Demise for Maine and Skid Ho for Dutchland. Grim Demise in front right now, but Skid Ho trying to get through.
And Grim Demise does take the lead. She just was not afraid of those arms in front of her. She just kind of dove through them. And I think that when you encounter blockers sort of like touching each other that way, you just have to know that it's okay to bust through that wall. So Grim Demise coming around on her scoring pass as she is through. And she does take 5 points for lapping the other team's jammer, although Skid Ho's right behind her.
Big grand slam for Grim Demise. Now she's going to have a decision to make. She's approaching Treasure Chest, who just got back into action. She calls off the jam. Smart play. And Maine continues to pull this thing within reach. Grim Demise with a 5-point jam.
We've got 11 minutes left in this half. And Max, do you think that 59 points can be scored in 11 minutes?
Oh, 59 points can be scored in about 5 minutes, Pixie.
Couple of jams. It could happen.
We've got a timeout on the track called by Maine. We want to thank Dr. Hauschka. This is Dr. Hauschka's house today to some extent. He's got a beautiful table right at the beginning of the foyer as you walk into Dew Burns Arena. Dr. Hauschka celebrates the fresh faces of the WFTDA. If you're in the area, stop by the booth and get your fresh face. They have amazing bruise healing and skincare products designed specifically for the female athlete.
Also, just want to mention Flat Track Revolution. Wear your passion at flattrackrevolution.com. They are also one of our sponsors. We're so grateful to all of the sponsors of the 2011 WFTDA East Region Playoffs. Again, this is the first bout. We are hoping that you will be tuning in for more than one today. Coming up at noon, we have the Carolina Roller Girls playing the London Roller Girls. Carolina is the number 7 seed in the East, and London is the number 10 seed in the East. They hopped across the pond to come over here and duke it out, and we are so excited to watch them play.
You know, Pixie, I'm just kind of wondering, for those of you who are at work streaming this, and I don't even know. I mean, I guess you could turn off, kind of disable your email for a while. You certainly want to take your phone off the hook if anybody still phones people at work. But, you know, because after Carolina and London, we have another international match at 2 p.m. that's going to knock your socks off. It's Steel City and Montreal. And, Montreal and London, both teams that a lot of people are talking about this year.
And I just got information from our announcer, ref, that Maine had requested an official review on a track cut. And it was determined that the correct call was made on that cut. So just so you know, that's what the timeout was for. It was an official timeout. And I think it was on Maine's Jammer in that last jam.
Crystal Whip is on the line now for Maine and White Thrash for Dutchland, but there's still some controversy going on here, Pixie. Can you explain a little more about that?
There definitely is. If you're just tuning in, you know, we've got Maine, the number 9 seed, going up against Dutchland, the number 8 seed. And these two teams are so well matched. They have been duking it out. The score has gone back and forth. Right now, Dutchland is in the lead by about 59 points. But as I've said previously in this bout, Maine plays very well in the second half. And so they have kind of come back, and we're looking to see if they can continue to do that. Although, right now, we've got Skid Ho from Dutchland as a lead jammer.
And well, that's so, White Thrash, if I may.
I'm sorry, White Thrash, my apologies, as the lead jammer.
Crystal Whip still having a hard time getting around. Bella Loblosi and Treasure that's Jolene Jawbreaker now, who's seeing some action for the All-Stars.
And we just had a major track cut called on White Thrash. So Crystal Whip has a power jam opportunity here. Also, Jolene Jawbreaker out on a major. So, you know, now Dutchland is down a blocker, and they have no jammer on the track. Hopefully, we have, you know, Maine will have the opportunity to score some points here, or at least break apart that amazing three wall that Dutchland keeps putting up front.
Crystal Whip is having a tough time with Hillbilly Hellcat in the back and Bella Loblosi and Roman Choke in front. Now she's starting to put on the power, but Hillbilly Hellcat knocks her out of bounds. She's trying to call off the jam. Problem is, I don't think she's been through yet. Now she gets through.
And she is not the lead jammer, so she's through, but she's going to have to keep skating and keep trying to pick up points. Now, maybe with a little bit of momentum, it will be easier for her to get on the pack. Hillbilly Hellcat out in the penalty box, but now we have got White Thrash back.
Things starting to slow down a little bit in the pack. Again, I think this 10 a.m. start, a little difficult for both teams as they are, play has been a little ragged, quite honestly, over the last couple of jams. There's plenty of effort and plenty of desire on the track, but seems like we have a timeout now called by Dutchland as they want to figure things out. We want to thank Rydell Skates, the proud partner and official skate of the WFTDA, along with Adam Wheels, the official wheel of the WFTDA, sponsoring this broadcast along with this whole event. And if you can't be here in Baltimore, Pixie, next best thing is Blaze Streaming Video.
Absolutely. Blaze Streaming Media does a fantastic job. If you don't have the high definition feed, I highly recommend upgrading. It's $10 a day. It's $20 for the whole entire tournament. And then if you wanted to, you know, for example, watch all of the Big Five, all of the WFTDA regional playoffs and the championships, $80 will get you there. Plus, you'll be able to have access to the archived bouts afterward. How much better can it get in high definition? You can see the faces, you can see the numbers. It's so exciting to watch.
Derby fans around the world are going to be archiving and accessing some of these bouts for years to come, Pixie. I mean, we've got history being made at these East Regionals. The next game, Carolina versus London.
And now it looks like we have a timeout being called by Maine. Right, following the Dutchland timeout, Maine called a timeout. So we've got a little bit more time to chat about our sponsors. We love Derby Skins. Derby Skins loves making your hiney shiny. They have those fantastic fitted derby shorts that you have seen shining on the posteriors of skaters all over the country.
Several of the Dutchland skaters are wearing the Derby Skins. Champions. And actually, as the home announcer for the Harrisburg area roller derby Nuclear Knockouts, I know Nasty Ness, founder of Derby Skins. She used to skate for the Nuclear Knockouts. She, along with her mother, started the company about 3.5-4 years ago, and it's taken off and it's gone worldwide. They actually made my announcer jacket. And we're back to the action.
And we have Grim Demise going up against Nashville, and Grim Demise contending with that two wall up at the front. It looks like it's Raven Revenge and Rum and Choke that are holding her back. Crystal Whip trying to break them up and help Grim out. Nashville is through. She is not the lead jammer. That honor will belong to Grim Demise if she can get past Raven and Rum and Choke. They are just really forming the tightest wall possible. Nashville and coming around to the back of the pack. Grim Demise is through, takes the lead, calls it, and Nash picks up one. Nothing for Grim on that one.
That's good second effort for Grim Demise, though. She knew she had to get through, or she, you know, the time is winding down. The clock is Dutchland's friend at this point with a 65-point lead. Maine's got to make every jam count, and Shirley B. Slammin' will be wearing the star for the Port Authorities in this next jam. If you're just tuning in, of course, Maine in white.
And Dutchland in black, Skid Ho on the jammer line for Dutchland. And we've only got two blockers on the track for Dutchland. We've got Bella Loblowski and Milk Maiden. And that gives Shirley B. Slammin' an advantage, which she uses to get lead jammer.
And Shirley B. Slammin' working as hard as she can. She's got a lot of ground to pick up now. And we have a cut track called on Skid Ho. That's four minors. She's going to have to sit down. Power jam for Maine just when they needed it the most. Now Maine's going to try to hold the pack down in speed, give Shirley B. Slammin' the opportunity to get as much as she can. Dutchland's got other ideas. Itsy Bitsy Fighter holding off Jolene Jawbreaker. That gives Shirley B. Slammin' an opportunity to get at least one. And Bella Loblowski up front for Dutchland along with Pivot.
It looks like Maine's doing a good job at holding, you know, slowing the pace of the pack down. But what they need to do is do that and simultaneously break up the front wall. And so I think that that was where their challenge lies. You know, Shirley B. Slammin' did a great job getting lead jammer on that jam, calling it off so that it looks like we're going to start off with just one jammer on the line. That would be Grim Demise. Skid Ho still in the box for Dutchland.
At this point in the game, if you don't have the gas in the tank and you're the jammer on a power jam, you do want to call it off. As that way, the next jam starts with a fresh jammer for your team. They can spring out in front, and that's what Grim Demise is going to try and do right now. Look at that. She's got the inside on Spinal Snap, and she's off to the races. Now what Maine has to do is break up that wall, and to do that, they've got Crystal Whip, they've got Spinal Snap trapped in the back. That's gonna help as Grim Demise looking to get around Treasure Chest.
She's trying the inside. It didn't work. Now she's going to the outside. She sees Twisted Scissors there. Twisted Scissors sees her and gives her a booty block, but she didn't manage to knock her out.
Skid Ho back on the track for Maine, and Crystal Whip gave a little, she's called off on a low block.
This is rough. We have got two jammers on the track now. Skid Ho trying to get through. Grim Demise is the lead jammer. I don't think she's going to let Skid Ho get points. I think Grim's just going to try and pick up as many points as she can on this last pass. She's going to have her eye on Skid Ho at all times. And the moment Skid Ho gets close to that pack, Grim is probably going to call it.
And like there you see it right there. Good call, Pixie. As Renegade Raven, again, holding off Grim Demise. The blocking by Dutchland is what has been the difference in this game so far. But 4:15 left. If Maine's going to bring it, Maine's got to bring it right now.
And we have Shirley B. Slammin' on the jammer line for MRD, and it looks like we've got Nash Villain for Dutchland.
Nash Villain, the explosive jammer for Dutchland in a situation like this. She's either going to get 15 points or go to the penalty box, quite honestly. And it looks like she's going to get through, but she's not lead jammer.
That was a track cut, and so not the lead jammer. Shirley B. Slammin still fighting to get through the pack. Dutchland formed a wall at the back, and it looks like Shirley B. Slammin got a penalty. She's going to be in the box. Power jam for Dutchland.
Power jam, Nash Villain. This could close the door as Nash Villain took a shot from Punchy O'Guts, but she was able to sustain it and get back on her feet. Now Dutchland slows things down.
Punchy O'Guts going out on a direction of gameplay penalty for that block that knocked Nash Villain down. And Nash Villain picks up 5 on that pass.
Clock rolling down to 3 now. Nash Villain showing the form of, as I said before, a former downhill racer. She's got the slalom moves down, Pixie.
And we've got another blocker in the box for a clock for a direction of gameplay penalty. I think that would be Mother Bones. And so Maine's got jammer in the box, 2 blockers in the box. This is rough toward the end of this game, I'll tell you.
Nash Villain, though, can't stand the prosperity, and she goes off the track on a back block called. That's going to bring Shirley B. Slammin back onto the track, but it might be too little too late as Nash Villain is going to hold on to those points that she scored. Dutchland 185, Maine 113.
And we've got Crystal Whip going to the box for MRD, and it looks like we've got Punchy coming out very soon, but right now we only have 2 Maine players on the track. We've got Shirley B. Slammin and May Snap, who just had a pig pile with White Thrash.
And the jam times out. Coming up to the 1 minute and 50 second mark. Dutchland with the 185-113 lead. Not for lack of effort on the part of Maine. Maine going to start off with Grim Demise on the jam line.
Looks like this might be our last jam. It really depends, but we've only got 1.5 minutes left in the period, and it's just Grim. One blocker in the box for Maine. Roller Derby Crystal Whip is in the box.
Twisted Scissors, Milk Maiden, Renegade Raven on the line for Dutchland, but Grim Demise gets through as lead.
Absolutely. So we've got Maine down 2 blockers. So we've just got Itsy Bitsy Fighter and Mother Bones on the track with Grim Demise as the lead jammer.
Nash Villain back on the track. She was paying attention to that penalty timer, and she wanted in as soon as she could. She's going to make this pass. Tries to get around Itsy Bitsy Fighter. She does. Itsy Bitsy Fighter throws herself out of bounds, trying to get a body on Nash Villain. Now Grim Demise is putting the power to her, trying to get as much as she can. How about that shot from Renegade Raven to Grim Demise, sending her way off stride?
And Grim Demise tried to call the jam. She got knocked out. She tried to call the jam, but she got a penalty, and so she was not able to call it. Now she's in the box, and this jam is going to finish without her.
And Nash Villain will take this one home for Dutchland with 8 minutes left on the play clock. That's just about going to do it.
We've got 33 seconds on the jam clock. That is what we're running for time. So even though you see the period clock has run down, folks, the jam ends at its natural conclusion. That's in about 23 seconds now.
Nash Villain looking to get around Itsy Bitsy Fighter, and she can't do it. Itsy Bitsy Fighter gets what she needs on her. An effective blocker, not just a jammer, is Itsy Bitsy Fighter for Maine.
Little Punisher just took Nash Villain out on the inside. Maine is not going down easy. There we go again by Little Punisher. Number 100 proof. She is strong.
And that's it. We jam times out. We're going to wait for the official word. We certainly never like to call a game before the officials say that it's over, but I think it's over, Pixie. 194-117 in favor of the number 8 seed, the Dutchland Derby Rollers.
What a way to kick off the 2011 WFTDA East Region playoffs. I'm telling you, that was some exciting derby, Max.
That was amazing, and Maine stayed in it. Like you said, they came back in that second half and scored the first 35 points before Dutchland was able to regroup. Now both of the teams are shaking hands, giving each other some smiles. Dutchland wins the opportunity to face off against the number one seed. Susie Hot Rod, Bonnie Thunders, and company for Gotham. So those of you who pay a lot of attention to the East region this year know that Dutchland's got their work cut out for them, and they won't be doing it on a lot of rest.
Absolutely. And I think that that's pretty much a wrap for us, but I want to have our fans at home to stay tuned for Carolina Roller Girls versus the London Roller Girls coming up at noon. After that, we have, this is going to be an amazing bout, number 4 seed versus number 5 seed, Steel City Derby Demons at number 4 versus number 5 Montreal at 2 o'clock today. So if you're getting out of work early, you know what you're doing at 2. And then also later on, stay tuned for the Charm City Roller Girls, number 3 seed, versus the Boston Derby Dames, number 4 seed. A really exciting day of derby coming up. Right, Max?
Absolutely, Pixie. And, you know, you said if you're getting out of work early. I know, you know, if you're at work, you can impress the boss by acting like you're working late tonight. Just stay in front of your computer and watch all these bouts. And I was very happy to be here with Pixie and be here with you today, bringing you this bout. Sachin Victim and Lady O'Shawn are going to bring you Carolina versus London. Get yourself a snack, get yourself another cup of coffee or whatever you prefer, and stay right here with Blaze Streaming Media all weekend long for the 2011 WFTDA East Region Playoffs.
Thank you, Max.
This is the Reverend Almighty at the Eastern Region Playoffs, standing alongside V Diva of the Dutchland Rollers that just beat Maine Roller Derby 198-117. V Diva, how is the game?
Actually, they were really hard. This is probably my first game playing against the best of the top 10 in East, and it was a challenge, especially after making Team USA. I thought them girls were really hard, but Maine really gave a really hard, tough fight, especially their number. I think her number was like 310, 305 or something. She was amazing out there. So
they definitely did have a strong defense. You guys went 45-45. You were tied. And then for the next 17 minutes, you guys held them to no points, scoring 60 points on your own, sent them into the locker room. Now, rumor has it, I need to ask the question, how many times did you throw up at the locker room at halftime?
I actually puked like 5 times. I was actually, cream cheese does not help when you play before a bout, but I'm not used to waking up early in the morning, especially working third shift. It was a challenge, but you know what? I gave it all for the second half, so.
So V Diva comes in, skates an incredible first half, goes, throws up in the bathroom 5 times, comes back out and has an incredible second half. You guys really adapted your game. I saw that after Maine started to come back, they started the progression. You guys then locked them back in, a lot of good trapping in the back. Anybody on the Maine team that you really give a big shout out to, a lot of heavy hits to?
Actually, they all were heavy. They really had defense. They had a wall in the back, and I was pretty much telling my blockers, I'm going to stay in the back and push them out, and I just took the outside. But it was a lot of footwork. And, I mean, I can't just pick one because they all were amazing out there. So.
And we all know your next game now is up against the dominant force of the East Coast, Gotham. Do you have any game plan going in? Do you have any? What's going on in the Dutchland mind right now?
We're just going to play what we do best, play derby. I mean, Gotham is number one out there. But, yeah, I can't say we're scared. We're just going to give what we can give. It's our first time against them, so what could you do?
Actually, your first time against Gotham is always best. V Diva, thank you for being here. Good luck this afternoon. I'm the Reverend Almighty. Having a good day.